Good morning. This is Dr. Vineet Chauhan. In the subject of BM553, the financial reporting, today we will check out the final accounts of the companies. The final accounts of the companies are divided into three parts: the balance sheet or statement of balance sheet, profit and loss statement or income statement, and cash flow statement. Out of these three, the first two are mandatory for a company, and that is as per the Companies Act 2013. We are discussing today the balance sheet and final accounts with cash flow, which is as per the Companies Act 2013. The balance sheet which is made as per Companies Act 2013 is as per the Schedule 3, which includes the statement format of balance sheet. The statement format of balance sheet includes the statement format for preparing the final account. This format starts with the equity and liability, and it will start with the liability side first. In this part, we have the details, we have notes of accounts number, figures for the current year, and figures for the previous reporting period. The figures which is shown by the company in the statement is for the two consecutive financial years, so that it will be used for a comparison of the previous year. The liability side of the balance sheet start as a first part, that is equity and liability. Here the equity and liability starts with the shareholders fund, which includes all the amount invested on behalf of the shareholders into the company. It includes first the share capital, which is the amount of capital invested by the company's shareholders. Further, the amount of profit which is earned by the company, but which is not being given to the shareholders as a dividend, is written here as a reserve and surplus. Thereafter, sometime company will receive the money against the share warrant. So that money is also shown here in the shareholders fund, because it is paid by the shareholders. Next, share application money, which is pending for the allotment. The company has taken the money, application money, but allotment is not being made. So that money is also shown in the shareholders part here. Thereafter, the third part starts with the outsiders liability, that includes the non-current liabilities. The non-current liabilities are also written in four parts in the balance sheet statement, that is long-term borrowing, means the borrowing which is taken by the company for the period of, or for the purpose of taking the loan, is for the period of more than one accounting year. This includes the loan which is taken from the banking as well as non-banking financial corporation. Then the deferred tax liability, since company has to pay the tax on its income in advance to the income tax authorities, that is why there is always a difference between the tax paid and the actual tax. So that is why the deferred tax liability is created, which is the difference between the actual tax and the tax paid, because company also pays the tax on the basis of MAT requirement, that is minimum alternative tax. So that is why the deferred tax liability or assets is being created, which is here. The other long term liabilities, if they are there, it will be included here with the last point of the non current liability, that is long term provision. When company will make the provision for long term, like depreciation provision, assets replacement provision, then it will be written here. The last or the fourth part of the first part of company's balance sheet or the liability side is current liabilities. The current liabilities includes the liabilities which is due for the period of short term, which is less than one accounting year or one accounting period. It includes the short term borrowing, means the loan taken by the company for very short term, trade payable or accounts payable, which is to be paid in a short time. The other current liabilities, which is not included in short term borrowing or trade payable, that will be written here. And if a provision which is created as a provision for liability for short term is written here. So this will be the total of one side of the balance sheet. And in the statement format, the second part also begins with the same heading, and that is that starts with the assets. The assets are classified into the fixed assets and the current assets. Previously, now it is being classified into two part: non-current assets and the current assets. The non-current assets are also divided into fixed assets, which is tangible fixed assets, means the assets which we can see, we can touch, we can feel. Intangible assets, which will be the assets which we cannot touch or feel. The tangible assets includes the building, plant, machinery, etc., while intangible assets includes patent, trademark, copyright, etc. If assets is under the process of being made, in that case the amount which is paid by the company for this purpose is called the capital work in progress. So the capital work in progress is also shown here. Thereafter, if there are intangible assets which is also under the development, like for a medicine company, the expenditure of the research lab which is used for the purpose of manufacturing or inventing a new drug, then the expenditure is called as intangible assets under development. The non-current investment is also included as the part of non-current assets. Non-current investment includes those investment which is taken by the company for long term period. If there is a deferred tax assets, means company has paid more tax than the tax is payable, then it is called deferred tax assets, which is written here. If when the company pays long term loans and advances to either the subsidiary company or the outsider, then it will be written as long term loans and advances in the assets part of the company. Thereafter, the other non-current assets, if company has other non-current assets, that will also be written here as other non-current assets. The second part of the assets part is current assets. Current assets includes those assets which is kept by the company for the period of the short term and which will be changed in each accounting period at least once in a year. It includes the current investment, which is the investment, but the maturity period is in the current period or in this year. The inventories or raw material, work in progress or finished goods. Trade receivables are the receivables from whom we have sold our goods to credit. Cash and cash equivalents, which includes cash balance and bank balance. If we have given short term loans and advances to anyone in our company or the external party, that will be written here. And other current assets will be written in this part. By this way, the total of 1 and 2 will be equal. So this is the format of the balance sheet, which is for the period, for the purpose of Companies Act 2013. Now we will be going ahead to check out the statement of profit and loss account, which is the income statement, for which is the second statement made by the company as a mandatory requirement under Companies Act 2013. As per the Companies Act 2013, there are two compulsory formats which has been provided by the Company Act under the Schedule 3rd. It includes the profit and loss statement, which is the second one. The profit and loss statement is also made by the same way as the balance sheet was being made. It has a particular notes of accounts number, figures for the current year and figures for the previous year for the purpose of a comparison. The profit and loss statement starts with the revenue from the operation, which is the income of the company from its operation. It also includes the other income, which is the income earned by the company by the other means, not by the sale of the company's product. And thereafter, the total revenue means the total earning which is the total of point number 1 and 2. Thereafter, the out of the total income, the expenditure is being reduced. For this purpose, the expenditures are divided into certain part, like cost of material consumed. The material which is used for the production will be written here. The purchase of stock in trade, whatever is the purchase we made for stock in trade not included in the raw material consumed will be written here. Change in the inventory, which means that change in the stock in trade and work in progress in the opening and closing balances. The employee benefit expenses and finance cost is the amount which is paid to the employees and which is paid as a salary, wages, etc. to the employees. The depreciation and amortization expenses will also be written here in this part. The depreciation means the amount of reduction in the company's fixed assets, while the amortization is the amount of expenses or the amount of depreciation reduced from the intangible assets of the company. Other expenses are the expenses not covered in the above points, and after adding all of them, the total expenditure is being calculated. After reducing the total expenditure from the total revenue, which is in the previous slide, we will get the profit before exceptional and extraordinary item. There are some exceptional items which is allowed under the Income Tax Act, so those will be adjusted here, and thereafter we get a profit before extraordinary item and tax, out of which we reduce the extraordinary items and we will get the profit before tax, out of which we reduce the tax, current year tax and the deferred tax of the previous year. Thereafter we get the profit for the period from the continuing operation, means the business is going on and we are getting the profit, out of which we calculate the profit or loss from the discontinued operation, means the part or the subsidiary company which is closed during the period and which has a profit or loss, that will be adjusted. Thereafter the tax expenses on discontinued operations are also adjusted, because if the company has discontinued the operation, the tax treatment will change the total amount of profit from discontinued operation, so that will be adjusted and we will get the profit or loss from discontinued operation. And finally we have a profit and loss for the period of the current period. Out of the profit we calculate earning per share, which is calculated by dividing the profit for the period divided by number of equity shares. With this we will get the earning per share, which is called as a basic earning per share, and if there are some other adjustment, then we can also calculate the diluted earning per share. Suppose there are some shares which are with us and for that purpose we don't need to pay them dividend, so that will be reduced and we will get a diluted the earning per share. The third statement, which is made as per the Companies Act 2013, is the cash flow statement, but the format of cash flow statement is not being provided in the Companies Act 2013, and it is adopted or it is taken on the basis of the income tax the ICAI, that is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. The institute have developed two different statement format for cash flow statement, that was direct and indirect format, and as per the Companies Act 2013, they also have clarified that now only indirect format will be used, which starts from the net profit or loss before taxation. This cash flow statement is having three parts: cash flow from operating activity, cash flow from investing activity, and cash flow from financing activity. The operating activities means the business. Since the business will carry on for the period of 1 year, The net profit is the outcome of the company's profit which is taken before the taxation, out of which we make the adjustment for non-cash items and the current assets item. First, we make the adjustment for non-current items and non-cash paid items, that is depreciation which is not paid, the interest and finance charges which is reduced from the profit, provisions which is reduced from the profit, so it will be added, unrealized foreign exchange gain or loss, if there is a loss it will be reduced, if there is a gain it will be added in the calculation of profit and loss account, the profit. So the adjustment will be taken place for this purpose. Profit or loss on sale of fixed assets, the loss was reduced while we have calculated the net profit, so it will be added, while the profit is reduced because it has added while calculation of net profit. If we have interest or dividend income, that will also be adjusted here. With this, we will have net operating profit before working capital charge or working capital changes. Under the working capital changes, we include the adjustment which is for the current assets, that is for inventory, trade receivables, loans and advances, and other non-current assets. And if the amount of these non-current assets have increased, in that case, we believe that investment of cash is more and it will be reduced, while in case of liability, it will be vice versa. Thereafter, we will get the cash generated from the operation, out of which we reduce the income tax paid, and we will get the net cash from operating activities. We will move to the second part, that is investing activities. The cash flow from investing activities includes purchase of fixed assets for which the amount is being paid, proceed from the purchase, that is also the same, dividend received, proceed from the sale of fixed assets, interest received. These are the points which is received, but if we invest, then it will be reduced, it will be written in negative. So finally, we have net cash from the investing activities because we have purchased assets for the more amount and we have sold the assets of less amount with the less amount of interest received. That is why it is negative. The cash flow from financing activity is the third part. In this third part, we will add the impact of all the loans and liabilities which is being taken by the company, and with the dividend or dividend tax which is paid by the company. So it starts with the repayment of loan of the financing activity. If we repay the loan or if we receive the proceed from the loan, it will be written here. Proceed from or repayment of short-term loan is shown here. The any other award or any other amount which is received by the company for the financing activities will be written here. When company will issue the share capital, it will be included here. With the repayment of the share capital will be reduced. Interest and finance charges will also be part of this. So if we have paid, it will be reduced. Dividend and dividend tax paid will also be reduced. And in case of anything which we have earned from the interest, that will be added here. By this way, we will get net cash from the financing activities, and we will get the net increase or decrease by adding the cash from operating activities in the previous slide, cash from investing activities and cash from financing activities. In this amount, if we add the opening balance of cash, then we will get the closing balance of cash. So this should be made equal, or this should be checked with the help of the closing balance of cash. If it is equal, that means the cash flow statement made is correct. So these are the three statements including the cash flow. If we check it out in the company's real annual report, for the purpose of comparison with figures, I have taken annual report of Tata Steel Company for the period of 2014-15. The balance sheet of Tata Company shows the shareholders' equity, share capital and reserve and surplus, but purposefully they have written the notes and page number of the notes at the beginning. So that may be done by the company, that adjustment is allowed. The company has shareholders' fund, its part, non-current liabilities and its part, current liabilities and its part. This is the total of the first part of the company's equity and liability. Then company is having the non-current assets, the fixed assets and tangible and intangible with capital work in progress, the other investments and all with the current assets, and then this total will be equal to the previous total. So the both side total of the balance sheet is equal. The statement of profit and loss account, which is also made by the company, which also starts with the revenue. The revenue of the company normally written in terms of the revenue from the operation and the other revenue. The revenue from the operation is always adjusted with the excise duty, since the excise duty paid is also the part of the bill which is paid, which is given by the company to the outsiders for the purpose of sale. So that is why the excise duty, which is the government tax, which is the part of government income, that will also reduced here. So we will get the net revenue which we have earned with the help of our business. With this we add other revenue for getting the total revenue or the total income, out of which, as mentioned, the expenditure of raw material consumed, purchase of assets, changes in the inventory, employee depreciation expenses, finance cost and other expenses will be reduced, and if anything is transferred to the capital will be added, and then finally we will get the profit before exceptional items and tax, out of which the exceptional items like profit on sale of non-current investment, provision for on investment, provision for non-current assets, profit on sale of non-current assets, etc. are adjusted, and we get profit before tax, out of which we reduce the current year tax, the MAT credit and deferred tax, and we will get profit after tax. This is the profit after tax, and on the basis of nominal value per share 10 rupees, the basic earning of the company is calculated and diluted earning is calculated, which is moreover same because there is no difference in the number of shares of a company. The next statement is cash flow statement. The cash flow statement has shown the cash from operating activities. It starts with the profit before tax, as it is the indirect format, with the adjustment of depreciation, impairment of fixed assets, reversal, profit and loss on assets sold, finance cost, provision for wealth, etc. So this will be the company's profit before working capital charge, and out of this we make the adjustment for trade and other receivable, inventory, which is current part, and we will see the cash which is generated by the operation, out of which we reduce direct tax which is paid by the company, and we have cash from operating activities. Thereafter we make the adjustment for investing activities, purchase is reduced while sale of assets will be added with the dividend and interest received, so that we will have the net cash flow from the investing activities. As for the three part, the third part is cash flow from financing activity. These are the financing activities which has been shown by this company. Company has not issued any equity shares, that is dash. Capital contribution company has received, proceed from borrowing and repayment of borrowing is also being shown, and finally we will have the net increase or decrease in the cash or cash equivalents. By adding the opening balance of cash, we will get and the exchange rate changes, we will get the closing balance of cash. This should be similar to the closing balance, so that we will say that this statement or this cash flow statement total is equal and it is similar. Thereafter, the company provides notes on the balance sheet and profit and loss statement. The first number note is related with the accounting policy, the basis for accounting, the judgment, revenue recognition, employee benefit, tangible assets, intangible assets, depreciation policy, the impairment policy for intangible assets, foreign currency transaction which is made by the company in the previous year, derivative and financial instruments which is used by the company, investment, inventories, related policies, then the expenditure of research and development are included with deferred tax in the first notes of accounts. The first notes of accounts is moreover a theoretical reference for the purpose of the accounting policy which is used by the company. Thereafter, the detail of each and every expenditure which is written in balance sheet and in profit and loss account will be given or will be provided. The second notes of accounts number is of share capital, which provide authorized share capital, issued share capital, subscribed share capital, and paid up share capital. So these are the four types of share capital, out of which authorized means the total maximum number of shares which company can issue. The issued capital is the part of authorized capital which has been issued to the common people, and subscribed and paid up capital is the capital which is taken by the public and which is fully paid up. The number of ordinary shares which is used or which is issued to the public in cash will be shown with the total number of shares which is not being sold for cash but for other purposes are also being shown separately, because this company is not having that, so that has not been shown. Reserve and surplus, showing all the reserve, types of reserve and surplus of the company. The hybrid or perpetual securities shows the securities which is taken by the company. Borrowings, the amount of loan which is taken by the company from the sources are included in the borrowing. Deferred tax liability, the tax liability which is difference in the company's case because of difference in the tax paid and tax due is called as deferred tax liability, and assets is the assets which is the tax paid by the company more in respect of employee separation compensation or the provision for doubtful debts or any other reason. Other long term liabilities includes the other liabilities which is for the long term period. Provisions, trade payables are the creditors and others. Other current liabilities, any other liabilities than the trade payable. Then in the asset side, we have tangible assets. Each and every assets with the name are written in the column, and the gross block with addition and deductions adjusted, we will get a gross block at the end of the period. This is the gross block of freehold land and property. And thereafter, the similarly the accumulated depreciation is also written, and thereafter the intangible assets and amortization of intangible assets are written. This is the intangible assets and amortization. Then we have non-current investment, since the company invests in many places, in many other companies, so this schedule will be a longer schedule. Non-current investment, same is going on. Then we have loans and advances, which is for the long term period. Then we have after long term loans and advances, we have other current non-current assets which is shown here. Then we have current investment, the investment which is mature, which is going to be matured in the current accounting period or which is taken for a short period. Thereafter, we have inventory and inventories balance, trade receivable and their balance, cash and bank balance, other current assets. So these are the total 20 notes of accounts. minus the first one. So 19 are the notes of accounts prepared for the purpose of providing the detail of balance sheet item. Similarly, for the P&L account, we also have like revenue from the operation. The four part of the revenue is shown by the company that it has earned revenue from sale of the product, from sale of the power and water, from the town, medical and other services provided by the company, other operating income. Thereafter, the company will provide additional information regarding the product sold. So this is the additional information. The other income except the sale of the company's product is shown here. Since company has invested, so they have dividend income, interest income and other income. The company will also provide the detail of other expenditure, includes first as raw material consumed, the purchase of fixed, semi-finished and other product, other material, changes in the inventory, in the opening and closing stock difference, employees benefit expenses include salary, wages, PF, etc. Depreciation and amortization for the current year. Finance cost, which includes the interest and dividend. Other expenses includes these expenditure. Then we have exceptional item, that these are the exceptional item on which the tax is not being calculated, so that their impact is being reduced. Then we have earning per share. The earning per share is calculated on the basis of profit after tax, out of which the dividend on hybrid perpetual securities, since they are not subject to tax, will be reduced. And we got profit availability for EPS and profit attributed to ordinary shareholders. The contingent liabilities are also being shown. The value of imported material is also shown by the company. The earning of foreign income, the employee benefit cost and their expenditure, their provident fund, superannuation fund, etc. is also shown by the company. So these are the various schedules or the notes of accounts of P&L. Thereafter we have some additional reporting like segment reporting and other reports, which is also shown by the company and which is out of the subject of our today's lecture. So that ends our today's presentation, which includes the presentation of company's balance sheet, their notes of accounts, their P&L account, their notes of accounts and the cash flow statement. Thank you.